Welcome to my channel WinChem. Today we are going to see a John Teller distortion. Irrespective of high spin or a low spin, we have a distortion in D1 orbital, D2 orbital, D4, D7 and D9 orbitals. Other than these five, two more d orbitals are there which is having a John Teller distortion. What is a John Teller distortion? When it will occur? It will occur when the electrons in the d orbitals are unequally filled, okay, unsymmetrically filled. We can say as unequally filled electrons, okay. If the electrons are unequally filled, then we can say this is John Teller distortion. We can see one by one how this is a John Teller distortion and remaining on all not. The first one, high spin, d1 one electrons are spilled in the T2G orbital. This T2G orbital, this is AG orbital, here also T2G orbital, and this is AG orbital. T2G means triply degenerate orbitals, that is EG means doubly degenerate orbitals. One electron, so D1, this is unequally filled electrons, one is there. Here also this is unequally filled electrons and this is also there. And two, both are unequally filled electrons, so this John Teller distortion is there. And three, equally filled electrons, so no John Teller distortion. Okay, we can write over here, no John Teller distortion. In which case? D3 case. And D4. It's a high spin, there is no pairing is there, so it moves to the EG level, doubly degenerate orbitals EG level. And D4 distortion is there, mentioned over here. And here a low spin, so pairing takes place in the triply degenerate orbital itself. So here also, what is that? John Teller distortion is the unequally filled electrons. And again, 5, there is no distortion, is there, equally filled. And here, if it comes over here, John Teller distortion is there. So here a D5 low spin John Teller distortion is there. And here 6, D6, here D6 high spin John Teller distortion is there. Other than these 5, the two things which is having a John Teller distortion, which is a D5 low spin and a D6 high spin. Okay, keep it in your mind. D5, 5 is a low one, this L. And the 6 is a higher one and H, high spin. And 7th one, if you move to the 7th one, here the 7th one, here the 6th one, there is no distortion in the low spin. Leave it. And 7th one here, the distortion is there and mentioned over here. And here also, distortion is there, unequally filled, distortion is there and mentioned over here. Irrespective of low and high spin, distortion is there. And 8th one, here and the 8th one is 6, 7, 8. Okay, 8 one is here. If you see that here, 6, 7, 8. Here also there is no distortion. Equally filled. Here also equally filled. If you see this, irrespective of the low spin or high spin, there is no distortion in D8. Okay, D8 there is no distortion. And D9. If you go to this, D9. Distortion is there. Unequally filled electrons. D9. So distortion is there. And D10. There is no distortion. So there is no distortion means, what are all the three cases which we don't have a distortion? Means D3, D8 and D10. If you can able to memory these three also, it's better. But if you know these seven, it's more than better than this. Okay, more than good. Why? Because we should know which are all the things having a distortion. And D5 low spin, D6 high spin. This is the easy tricks. If you memorize these seven values, you can easily answer for all the questions related to John Teller distortion. Thanks for watching.